Hi, I'm Timothy Harvey for sci-fi4me.com and horror4me.com, and this is my video review for two episodes of Lucifer, Etu Doctor, and A Priest Walks Into a Bar, and this show is frustrating me greatly. So the problem is this. We have a show where the name of the show is Lucifer, and Lucifer is wildly inconsistent character. All right? In both these episodes, both Etu Doctor and A Priest Walks Into a Bar, and a significant chunk of the episodes we've had before, Lucifer is incredibly oblivious to the most obvious of things, and things he should not be oblivious to. Okay? He is the first angel. He is the first of the fallen. He is the Lord of Hell. He has been here for the entire run of humanity. And he had his comprehension of human nature only goes to the sin part. That doesn't make any sense whatsoever. See, here's when you're adapting a comic as rich as the Vertigo Lucifer series, and I've written about this before and I've talked about this before, you just can't do it for television. So they made some changes, obviously. But they kind of made Lucifer into a moron. A very smart moron, but when it comes to matters of that he should really, really understand, he doesn't. The idea in Etu Doctor that he would be jealous, okay, sure, why not? Jealousy is, after all, a sin. But oblivious to his own jealousy and in denial of his own jealousy, his level of self-awareness is ridiculously low. And it's really hard to believe when you're looking at a character. The devil. Okay? And he's not the stereotypical devil. And that's one of the things they brought over from the Vertigo series. He's someone who's doing a job that he doesn't like. So the idea that he would be just this daft when it comes to understanding these things is really, really hard to swallow. And it's bugging me greatly. So, but it also carries on into A Priest Walks Into a Bar. In both cases, you have him acting in a way that just doesn't make any sense whatsoever. Now, on the plus side, we had some really good things happen in Etu Doctor. First of all, we got Rachel Harris, Dr. Linda Martin, out of the office and out into the world. You know, she's basically shut Lucifer off. It's going to have a professional relationship now. She realizes that what she was doing is unprofessional and as much sexy time as they're having. No, she's done. And here she's out and she's helping with the investigation. And she is a strong, opinionated, and intelligent woman who makes a difference in the story. And it's really, really nice to see because Rachel Harris is a great actress. And so it's nice to see her have a chance to do more in the show than just be in the office being Lucifer's confessor. And trying to deal with the fact that he's oblivious as all hell. Pun intended. So, the other important thing we get out of Etu Doctor is Malcolm, the cop from the Palmetto case, who Chloe was basically trying to, figure out how he was dirty, and then they take him off life support, and he dies, and then Aminadel shows up and brings him back, and there's something going on here. Well, his partner ends up dead. Looks like a suicide. Looks like he's the one who's responsible for getting Malcolm shot. But this is a setup. Malcolm killed his own partner. And Detective Dan, who I've been sitting there going, this is great. Detective Dan is a good cop with a great family. And he's trying to do the right thing. And he's not great at it, but he's trying. Turns out to be the guy who shot everybody at the Palmetto warehouse. So, I mean, Kevin Alejandro plays a great bad guy, but it was kind of nice to see him play what appeared to be a good guy. But, yeah. We get a little more information as we go into A Priest Walks Into a Bar, because A Priest Walks Into a Bar brings in Coleman Domingo playing Father Frank, who's actually tracked down Lucifer to, because somehow the word that Lucifer can help you, which we really haven't seen in the show before, has made it out on the streets. And Father Frank comes looking for Lucifer because he's got this kid that he feels responsible for and wants to help. And the kid is at a youth center which is apparently involved in a drug ring, and he thinks the kid's getting caught up in that, and the guy running the youth center, the priest is convinced, is behind the drug ring, and he wants Lucifer to help. And Lucifer's like, no, I'm not going to help you. You know, and he says all the things you would say to a priest in this day and age. So the accusations of pedophilia and just all the horrible things. And Lucifer just says it. And it just rolls off Father Frank. And he just goes, no, you say what you want to say. Damn, whatever. And it's really a nice dynamic here. For all the frustrations I have with this show, this kind of episode goes a long way to try and pull that back. So you'll have something like Etu Doctor, where you're sitting there going, really? Really? And then you have something like this, where you actually have a theological argument happening. You have Lucifer saying, you know, how can you believe, how can you have faith? How can you believe the things you believe? And the priest going, how can you not? You can, you know, God has a plan. And Lucifer's like, well, I know God has a plan. I didn't like his plan. And, you know, the priest is saying, well, I believe God. I have faith in God. And Lucifer's like, well, God didn't have faith in me. It's interesting. This is the kind of dialogue you want from this show. This kind of debate of you know, free will and faith and the dynamic between God and the devil and all these things that are potentially there for the show. What ends up happening is that these two men end up connecting to a degree. Because Father Frank's life has not been an easy one, and he lived a sinner's life for a long time. He was a musician, and the whole reason this kid is important to him is because the kid's father was a friend of his, another musician, and they were in a car one night, the kid, his parents, Frank, and Frank's daughter, and there was a car accident, and only Frank and the kid came out alive. Well, out of that tragedy, Frank found faith, and he found his belief in God. And it's really, really nice, actually, to see a man of faith portrayed positively in popular fiction. This is something that doesn't we don't always see, right? And there's reasons for that, and some of them have to do with the fact that we have a lot of negative religious figures in the world, okay? And they make good bad guys because, of course, they're held up to a standard. And when they fall hard. Well, here is somebody who doesn't fall. And when it comes time for the confrontation, when we discover that the head of the youth center ends up dead and Frank is the obvious suspect, but then it looks like the kid's involved, and you find out that ultimately another guy at the youth center is running this giant crime drug ring, using the kids for the mules, collecting the money, distributing the drugs. And he wants the kid to kill Father Frank to prove himself. Ultimately, Frank ends up taking a bullet for the kid, you know, and saves the kid. And Lucifer finds himself cradling the body of a dying priest, saying, this isn't fair. And we end up with this scene right here, Lucifer on the balcony of his penthouse, screaming at God, demanding to know how this works. Because Frank did everything right. Frank believed. Frank tried to help. Frank saved people. And he still died. How does it work? And this is the interesting questions this show could be asking all the time. But instead, we get, you know, what is essentially a procedural show. And let's face it, the crime of the week are the least important parts, right? This kind of stuff, this character interaction, this very, very daring in some respects. Because, you know, it's a show about the devil on primetime TV. Take a chance. Play with the theology. Play with the big questions. Right? It's not enough, okay? I like watching this show. It's fun. But it's very, very frustrating. So the other thing we find out here, of course, is that Detective Dan, who has now been partnered with Malcolm, has gotten an untraceable gun from the police lockup. He's given it to Malcolm. And we find out the reason why. And that's because Aminadel brought him back from hell. Malcolm died, was in hell for 30 seconds, and Aminadel pulled him out and gave him one mission. Kill Lucifer. Because if Lucifer dies, well, he goes to hell. And that's where they want him. So, this show is so uneven. But yet there's something here. So, I just need them to stop wasting Tom Ellis. Keep giving us Lauren German storylines like they've got going. And figure out what they want to do here. Because it's all over the place. Anyway, I'm Tim Harvey for Sci-Fi for Me, Horror for Me. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next week.